You know our worst reaction break away from any ungodly addiction? By turning to the word of Almighty God. All we have to do is just pick up our Bible from wherever we have it and start to read. This Bible that we have perhaps somewhere on our center table, perhaps somewhere on a shelf catching dust, perhaps somewhere in a bag until we're going to come to church the next time. All the instruction that God wants us to live, to have a good and prosperous life, is in this book. But we prefer it one day. We understand that, yes, physical exercise is good, and so we join the gym. Some people join the gym. Some people get up early in the morning and run. Bible tells us physical exercise is good, but body exercise is more fruitful. It gives us more of what God wants. This Bible, if you have read the Bible once and you haven't found something that removes that addiction that you have, then I ask you to read it again. Start your book. The Bible is a book of many examples. And those who resist temptation are overcome to be prominent people. Are listed in the Bible. There are many examples. Think of Joseph. Genesis chapter 39. You know this story well. Joseph is sold into slavery by some envious brothers and finds himself as a house slave in the house of Potiphar. He is tall, dark, and handsome. Doesn't look like me. He is noticed by Potiphar's wife. She wants an affair with him and will not rest at nothing, and will rest at nothing in an effort to have this man for herself. I can bet this was better than young and restless. This was better than days of our lives. This was better than all this will pop up that people think about. Here is a woman of power and authority. Needing a slave to be a partner, although she has no husband. And Joseph can have none of it. His mind was submit to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you. He was placed in a prison because of the interior. And you know the story. But at the end of it all, he was second only to the king of the land, the hero of that land.
Wow.
Compare this to David, 2 Samuel chapter 11. A man who had the word of God, understands the word of God, knows it well. What did David do? David goes on top of the roof. His eyes scan the place like a owl in the night. And perhaps days after days he was wandering, until finally he sees Bathsheba, and for the life of him, he could not have resisted what he saw. You know the story. Because of that, God said something to David. Later on, we read in that same chapter, when David wanted to build the temple, God says, "You're not going to build this temple for me. Because your hands are filled with blood." And he wasn't referring to the blood of Jesus that David would have shed under his instruction, but those who were shed innocently. If you remember the story well, Bathsheba's husband Uriah was sent to the front of the battlefield and was killed in battle, all because of the plan of David. So one man controlled himself, did not allow temptation to overrun him. The other man jumped right into it. Ever want us to the freak and swim and see how some people jump in? Without even testing the depth of the trip? Boo! The consequences of our action can be here. Compare this to the sins of a man in Achan in Joshua chapter 7. Joshua, they have crossed over into the Jordan. The people are asked not to take anything and take their own. But take them to the temple so that God can use them. And here's a smart man in Athens saying, so much gold, so much silver, so much of bronze. Let me have some. You know what happened to that story? 320 years old. Joshua chapter 7. His entire family perished because of one man. He messed up. There are many stories written so that we can hear that tells us we should never yield to temptation. Adam and Eve is a perfect example. You know, they had a perfect marriage in the garden. There was a man and a woman. All they had to do was walk in the garden in the cool of the day, eat grapes, corrupt pit mangoes, rub the head of the lion. Don't trouble that tree, as was instructed. Can you imagine? You have so much given to you. But it's the very one thing that God says, don't do, that caused Adam and Eve to be put out of the garden. But the devil is a liar. The devil has a lot of power, but he does not have power over you if you do not give him a chance. You see, Satan turns up with his famous formula. Fascination, form, and facts. Satan likes to fascinate us in. And so eventually, did God really say you shouldn't eat this apple? If you eat this apple, you will become like God. It fascinates our mind. And that's how sin is like my younger brothers and sisters. Like think of the older ones, like all the younger ones, you have a lot more technology to deal with. You see, let me tell you a little secret, which is no secret. Sin feels nice to the first, right? And afterwards, you catch it. The very thing that you are celebrating and feeling nice about, the same thing is often responsible for the downfall of men. Every kind of sin. So can you imagine the first time you slip some money from your mother or whoever and you never got touched? You know, it's nice because you get through. Same feels nice. And it went on and on and on until, as old people would say, every day bucket going to the well, and one day water will come out. Every time a man gets shot in kind of thinking in this country, you know, I always say, it can't be possible. I always say, bucket is going to the well every day, one day water will come out. And that's how sin works. It makes you feel good, fascinating in your mind. Eve felt good about what she heard. You would be like God. He created all of these things. Can you imagine if you could have a true revelation of yourself? And then present the form. It comes in the form of an apple. Take this apple and eat. She eats the apple. And she gives it to her husband. Prior to that, they were having a good time. Nobody had to cry out that the sun mocks. Nobody had to cry out that the day only gets 24 hours and sleep too late. That's why you can sleep all around the world, right? You know what the fact? An angel of the Lord turned up, just as God had said to them, the day you eat this apple, you will surely die. And that's the fact of life. When you champion and sin, the wage of sin is death. But I want to tell you that the free gift of God is eternal life. The ultimate story of temptation was with Jesus Christ. Jesus is tempted in every way, like all of us. There are three temptations that we see in chapter 4. But throughout the life of Jesus, he was tempted. I'm not going to go into it much. But just think of it. Even on the cross, one of those who are hung on the side of him and say, you say you could save people and now you can't save yourself? And in fact, we know Jesus could have saved himself. He could have called angels to release him. But Jesus, they say, Peter must still have the power to save himself. Have the power to say, not my way, but thy way be done. And sometimes as a people we need to understand that. It's not because you can do, you have the authority to do. Not because you can say, that is it. Use wisdom. Use example of God, that God has given to us in his book, to make sure that we live the life God truly calls us to live. Here is one way in which, here are two ways rather, in which you can overcome. And I know the message of Mr. Schock this morning, I believe. I have to get to control the temper. But I believe Jesus did not overcome this temptation because he was the Son of God. It was more than that. The Bible says, Jesus, filled with the Holy Spirit, was led by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. What did he go to the wilderness to do, church? He was here to fast, to pray, and to bend to the Lord. You see, in our greatest temptation, we must allow ourselves to say, God, not my will, but thy will be done. In our greatest temptation, we must be prepared to say, God, if it is you who allow me to be in this place, then you will also show me a way to get out of this place from the start. There is nothing that you, no place that you be. There will be no place that you will ever be right. That God in a order for us allowed to happen. Remember the story of Job? Even Job, when he was tempted, in all his temptation, God had to allow the devil to tempt him. When you're in a place, you might be in a bad situation, not where you want to be. God already remembers at the side of his mind. You're there because God wants you to be there. But in the same way, you must start asking God that despite all of the challenges, the temptations, allow me to come out on faith and on strength. On his own, Jesus would have been unable to be controlled. But the power of the Holy Spirit and the Word of God, he proved that all things were possible for those who believe. Every time Satan comes to him, you know what to do? The Word. It is written. It is written. It is written. It is the Bible. Was used by him, for the word of God is so good there, he studied it. And so when the devil presents his plan to us that might look good, fascinate us, and appear to be so good, God will give us the power to say, get me, my brothers and sisters, Satan always makes sin and all forms of sin look good. What is it that is sending you this morning? I do not know what is sending you. Jesus had his temptation. The first was, if you are a son of God, tell this stone to come bread. You know, Jesus would have done that to you before the death of him, but the death of him had an opportunity. Wait for his moment. Here is Jesus 40 days without food, hungry. This is another two times to get into it. So I'm still in the world. And if that wasn't enough, he was led up on a high place and showed him at the kingdom all the kingdoms of the world. All the kingdoms. Power. That means power. Can you imagine someone says, tomorrow I'm going to give you a promotion? And I to a movement from, let's say, a junior to a senior. We know persons who need to take a bribe and to sell out their brothers and to corrupt our whole country. But God is saying, you will not be temptation. And if that wasn't enough, the devil led him to Jerusalem, having stand on the highest point of the temple. And says, if you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here, for it is written, you will command his angels concerning you to hide carefully. They will lift you up in your hand, so that you will not strike your foot against the stone. And no doubt it is written, when you read that passage from the Psalm this morning, that's exactly what it says. So the devil wasn't quoting something that Jesus didn't know. In fact, he was spot on. But everything must be taken in context. You see, when you do, we must all understand this. It's not what we do, but the motive behind our doing. You see, if we can only do things and continue to do things because of the devil's instruction, then we will be tempted beyond what we can bear. Or we operate that way. You know what the Bible says? None of us will be tempted beyond what we can bear. And God will find a way of escape for us. Today God is finding an escape for all of us. Every temptation. You don't have to be a part of anything that you don't want. Just tell God that what is the situation. And He will redirect you. He will place an edge around you. Because we know that Jesus is powerful than Satan and sin. And if God on our side, we can be sure that the victory is ours. May we continue to listen to God's word. May we continue to read God's word. May we feed on it. So that when we are attacked and try to be encouraged by the devil, we can indeed win that battle, which will ever be present while we are alive. May God have His blessings to the word that you will hear this morning. Amen?
Amen.
Let us pray. We give you praise and thanks, O God, for your word. May your God never be tempted beyond what you can bear. And you have said that in your word. But we know, O God, that you can do, that we can do more. Help us, O God, to be watchful. Help us, O God, to be prayerful. Help us, O God, at this time to understand that we need to sanctify ourselves if we're going to live for you. We know, O God, at this time that the devil is ever raging war against your people. And right even in our village, things may be happening that seem not right. But we pray, O God, that our young men, our young women, would understand that these will pass. But if you remain in you, they will be blessed. And so we pray, O God, that everyone will hear these words. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Can we stand and sing? Thank you.